janefinch.com.
This evening, I have the pleasure and honor to introduce the recipients, Lydia Sun and Paul Nguyen, writers of Why Am I Still Alive? You just saw the clip of a moving story of a young Vietnamese suffering from a rare health condition and seeking medical assistance in dying, applicable to the plight of people in our society who face such situations. Ladies and gentlemen, let's please give a grand applause to this year's recipient of the 2019 CEMA Awards and Internet, Paul. Where's Paul? Nguyen and Lydia Sun. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, and honored guests, thank you for being here. To the board of the Canadian Ethnic Media Association, my team is touched by this prestigious honor. Thank you. Nearly 2 years ago, I received a message on Facebook from a complete stranger. He could only communicate by text or email. He was paralyzed, deaf, and mute. His name is Tommy, a 41-year-old Vietnamese man suffering from neurofibromatosis type 2, also known as NF2. We struck up a friendship that resulted in a visit to the nursing home where he lived. For the past 3 years, he is bedridden, waking up in the same room and not even being able to look out the window. Behind the scenes, I helped with small chores and looked for ways to assist. But Tommy was dealing with severe depression. Without hope, without a purpose, he questioned his reason to live. After getting his permission, we decided it was time to share his story. The ethnic media was crucial in helping spread the word. From local newspapers such as Thoi Mui and Thoi Bao, to Chinese websites like 51.ca, Tommy's story was shared in multiple languages across various platforms. The public response was strong. We received many calls offering friendship, kindness, and gifts. But I hope the story doesn't end here. I believe the spotlight cast by CEMA will enhance awareness about this rare disease. Tommy may not be able to hear or speak, but he does have a voice. As media workers, writers, producers, and storytellers, it is our responsibility to give a voice to the voiceless. I am thankful for the hard work and sacrifice of ethnic publishers who make sure that Canadians everywhere can create and disseminate news in their native language. You are giving a voice to all Canadians. You truly represent Canada. Thank you.